for you. Look out. And meanwhile, with everybody having college football on the mind, this is Clemson versus Oklahoma. Deshaun Watson versus Baker Mayfield. Bill O'Brien's won 8 in a row, despite starting the season at 0-3. Lamar Jackson Heisman Trophy winner is in Atlanta. That's a pretty huge game. Rams coming off their bye, taking on the Lions. The Chiefs now minus Kareem Hunt forevermore, taking on the Raiders late afternoon. Vikings Patriots tonight. Eagles Redskins tomorrow night. That is how, again, we are rolling on NFL Game Day morning, the morning of Week 13, man. December football has arrived, Steve Mariucci.
I know.
December football has arrived.
Here we go. This is football weather.
It is indeed. So
yeah,
I turn.
Yeah.
You're a dome guy.
Put a ball in the dome.
I know. You got South Florida and dome over there.
Right.
Okay. But I turn to our Iron Mountain Michigan man, our upper Peninsula King, to start us off with a Sunday thought. What do you have for me, Steve?
I promise you those people in Green Bay are fired up to see the white stuff come down right now. So this is the time of year, guys, where depth in your roster is very important. Okay? There are a lot of backup quarterbacks playing today in the league. None bigger than Chase Daniel for the Chicago Bears. He got his third start last week, and he delivered, beat the Lions. He's been playing for 10 years. He has three starts. Well, he's going to get another start today at the New York Football Giants. They've got to win this game to stay in first place. They have 5 wins in a row at 8-3. The Chicago Bears are counting on Chase Daniel.
And you guys know that players are motivated in a bunch of different ways. Sometimes it's to prove to a coach that they shouldn't have cut you. Sometimes it's to prove to a team that they shouldn't have passed on you. And sometimes it's to prove that you are the best of your class. So for me, I got my eyes on the Chargers and the Steelers. There's a lot riding on this game in the playoff picture, but there's also a lot of personal motivation between Phillip Rivers and Big Ben that want to show the world I was the best of the 2004 draft class.
Well, first, let me just say,
Oh my God. So here we go.
I really do, man. I love you guys.
Is it really,
man,
4 hours of this?
And I appreciate you guys allowing me to play today with this megaphone and everything. I just wanted to say that. I just felt like I needed to say that. But here's my storyline. Now, with what you talked about at the beginning of the show, Rich, with what's going on in Kansas City, that opens the door back up for New England to steal home field advantage. 6 of their 8 Super Bowls have gone through New England, including the last 5. When you give them home field advantage, hear my megaphone loud and clearly, they end up in the Super Bowl. In Kansas City, they got to go. They got to play Oakland twice. They'll see Baltimore, that great defense. They'll see the Chargers and Seattle. Just one game up on the New England Patriots, who play Minnesota today. It's about home field advantage right now for New England.
And thank you.
And, of course, then there's tonight's Sunday. Ian Rappaport joining us right now. You have the latest on Kareem Hunt, and take it away.
Rich, the baseline suspension for a personal conduct policy violation is 6 games, similar, of course, to what Kareem Hunt was shown doing in a video released by TMZ this week, assaulting a woman. I am told that Hunt is actually facing more than 6 games because the NFL is also, sources say, investigating a separate incident involving Hunt apparently punching a man in the face at an Ohio resort in June. The belief is they have enough to suspend him for both incidents, which, of course, they would be served together. So it could end up taking him into next season. And that being said, I'm also told by someone close to Kareem Hunt that what he may do, something on the table, is just say, I did it, try to speed up the investigation, try to serve these suspensions now rather than languishing on the commissioner's exempt list. One more note, Rich. I know there's been some question about who actually saw this video and when. I know the NFL and the Chiefs did not see the video. I'm told by a Cleveland police spokesman they did not see the video either until TMZ dropped it.